Welcome everyone. Welcome to Random Games with Splash. This is a segment when I play random games off at Steam or any other place. You just suggest them to me or I find them and I play them. That's basically how this is going to work. So, welcome to the first episode of Random Games with Splash. I hope you guys are ready for what you're about to watch. We're going to be playing Finding Paradise. This game is... sad, basically. It represents a lot of sadness in a lot of people's lives, basically. From what I could gather, I believe it's about two scientists or two doctors or two people trying to fulfill this old man's last wish through his memories, which is quite an interesting concept as it is, but whether they pull it off, we'll see. Looks beautiful already. Get out of the road, you little squirrel. Are you kidding me? It's got humor? Okay, well. Thank you. Thank you, Sir Squirrel. Explosive. Nuclear waste. Oh, Christ almighty, where am I going? What the shit, Eva? That's how you keep everyone alive, including the squirrel. Hope you learned something. Look, sometimes it's either us or them. Natural selection, I like this dude. By keeping ourselves alive now, we can be around to stop more self-inflicted critters. Critter casualties later. Logic. And lightning. We should be arriving at the patient soon. I could use a snack before then. Ooh, the glove box got some stuff. Do you mind? Well, only you would pack the glove box full of apples. Yeah, well, my nephew decorates the Christmas tree with them every year. And then I have to eat them for ages. Apples on a Christmas tree? Huh. Don't you dare say it. Don't you mean pineapples? That's horrible. Not gonna lie. I'm not hungry anymore. Fair enough. It's good to see that this game has humor, though. Ooh. Jesus Christ, man. What do you think you're doing? Ooh, check out this rad bike. Why can't we go to work on these instead? Because we are here to visit dead people, not to get ourselves killed. Really? I couldn't tell after the trauma of you driving like a stunt double. Besides, we are visiting half-dead people. Very different things. Yeah, well, let's hurry and keep it that way. All yours. Alright, mate. I'm going to take a quick cut, make sure everything's fine, make sure my recording's fine. I haven't recorded in a while, so I will be back to you in, like, you know, a few seconds, so don't worry. Alright, now we're back. Alright. He said, let's roll, and then, like a cucumber. What? You know, cucumber rolls. Sushi? Yeah, no. That's quite a stretch, which is very true. It's quite the stretch. Alright, where am I off to? I'm off to the house, I'm guessing. I say hi to the kids. There's a leaking sprinkler over there. Where? Where's the link? Leaking sprinkler. Hey now, what happened to you?
She kicked my teddy into the water.
Oh, bitch. Come on, man up. Yeah, well, it's a dumb bear. Just like your lame hair. Who looks like that? Potato, that's the name of the kid. But Ma said my bun buns are pretty. Yeah? Well, she also named you. Potato. That's actually pretty funny. Don't worry, we'll get your bear back. Actually, let me take care of this. Here we go. Why? What do you mean, why? I'm telling you, I got this one.
I mean, Dr. Watts said he has it, so he's got it, bro. I'm just saying.
Hey. What? Such an angsty teenager. Ha. Huh. Is that also hers? No, that's mine, you doofus. It's the new Rebel Doll X3000. They're cool because they got attitude and don't care. Just like you. I'm like a wimpy teddy bear. Yeah, my man, my man. Mr. Watts. That's pretty funny. Rip. Neil, what the jalapeno do you think did you do? What? What do you mean, what? You just took some kid's doll and kicked into the water. You could get sued for. Yay! Potato! You are my hero. No props, kid. In your face, bitch. Oh, you tell her, Potato. This is so messed up. Justice is cold and damp, Eva. Kinda like a tuna. I don't understand what this humor is, man. I mean, should we get the bears for them? Surely we get a stick and grab them. Yeah, well, come back another day. Where am I off to? Good soundtrack, though. Into the house we are. Hola, hola. Is this an elevator? What the hell is this? Ah, oh, it's a transmitter. Hello. Hey there. This is Dr. Rosaline, and Dr. Watts from Sigmund. Sigmund Freud? You're actually here. Yeah. Hope we're on time. Are you letting us in? Oh, sweet. I'll wait outside the door for you. What was that? What was what? Did you feel the blast of ice through the monitor? Well, if she's the patient's spouse, then she's got a dying spouse. It's not like we're here to lay out a picnic. Alright, maybe it's just me. Wait, mate. Who are you? Dave. Hello, may I help you with something? We can wait till you set that down, my box-carrying comrade. Thanks, bro. You really get me. That's pretty funny. I'm gonna lay on top of this. Yeah. So it's got his way, basically. Alright, well. Here to fulfill someone's dying wish, huh? How'd you know? This is the second time I've seen a visit from your company this week. Who is it this time? Colin Reeds. Know of him? The retired pilot, yeah. He lives on the top floor. Go on and give him the happy ending he deserves, probably. Is this To the Moon? I don't know, this is so similar to the Moon. I haven't played To the Moon, but isn't it the same concept? How you fulfilled a man's dream to go to the moon? Is this what this game is? I can't. Alright, top floor, here we go, baby. Let's get on this, baby. Let's take this elevator ride, baby, come on. Still carrying that box. Spouses, am I right? Always make the job so cumbersome. Depends on the person. Very true. It does all depend on that person. Whether it's an asshole or a nice guy, you never know. Dr. Rosaline, is it? And Dr. Watts, ahem. Yes, we're here for Colin. Of course. Thank you both for coming. Right this way. Yeah, she seems a bit depressed, cold. Written by Ken Guao. Babe. Man up, babe. Come on. Act 1. Tell me, what do you want to change? Huh. This is a quaint place you got here. Collins is in the other room. Come with me. Yeah, she does not want to talk to him. Right down to business. I like that. Do you actually? Yeah, because right now, I just really need to put this box down. I like this. I like Watts. He's pretty lit. Pretty edgy. This is the room, right? Oh, it's a model of a small fixed wing aircraft. An unplugged computer. The lamp. He's up here, isn't he? Here he is, alright. Asher, you must be here for my father. You're the patient's son. Yeah. I came as soon as I heard. But we can talk later. Why don't you get set up first? That box looks heavy. See? He gets it. He knows. My man.
Hey. Hey, gang, gang. Hey. Creep on blah.
Jeez. A song of solid hydrogen, monoxide, and rapid oxidation. Repassage. And then they, too, succumbed to their mortal wounds as the last of the... No, thanks. Reminds me too much of my job. Oh. When you get too real, eh? Where am I setting this stuff down, eh? As life support? It's a bit harsh, I think. Alright, what am I doing? Is looking there really necessary? Okay. Where is the medical doctor? He's here. He just went to the washroom. Is that table over there enough to get set up? Yeah, that'll do. Are you guys ready to get set up? Set the machine down. Yeah, just give us a moment. Should I like put a voice on? I don't know. I mean, I've got a little bit deep for Asher. I'm not doing a female voice, I'll tell you that. Is the power here sufficient? Why does everyone keep asking that? It'll work fine, sheesh. But first, brace yourselves for a power outage of cinematic proportions. Jesus. That's some advanced tech, baby. Huh. I guess you got a more stable power grid than our headquarters. That's equally comforting, as it is worrisome. You're in good hands. We do this all the time. Too much of the time, if you ask me. So you too are for real. What do you mean? You can really fulfill his wish. We'll certainly try our best, ma'am. But we always succeed because it would only be in his head, though. Not like he'd be able to tell the difference. Anyhow, first up, what is it that he wants? He wouldn't tell us. He said it doesn't affect us, and we have nothing to worry about. Well, that sounds legit. Look, that's okay. We'll find out from him soon enough. Isn't it always in the paperwork? Or isn't it also in the paperwork? Yeah, but who reads that stuff? I'm kidding. But seriously, where did the file go? It wasn't in the box. Nope, guess I might have left it in the car. Alright, I guess we got time while the machine's booting up anyway. Dr. Watts is currently doing the computer, so I'll get Rosalind. Well, someone's gotta go get it, and that someone could be you. But you were the one who forgot it. Exactly. Do you want me to go back and forget it again? Ayo, that's just Dr. Watts, baby. He don't care, baby. Let's go. I've updated the system. It's practically configuring itself now. Cool. That'll save some time. Already down to business, huh? How long were you in there for, mate? Hey, I recognize you. Yeah, it's been a while. Although, weren't Dr. Winters and Dr. Lynn assigned to this pension instead? Yeah, but they had a full roster at the time, so we took over. Saved their asses. Ironically, turned out they got nothing to do today. I guess you never know the timing with the nature of your job. Anyhow, don't mind me. I'm just gonna go check on the patient. Oh, wait, what am I doing? Am I going to retrieve the stuff? That's what I'm doing. Is there anything I can help you with? I'm just gonna go get something from the car, but you could show Dr. Watts around in a bit. Okay, understood. Sweet. Hey, you should probably go get Colin's monitor from Mr. Doctor. Mr. Doctor. Over there first. Yep, on it. Mr. Doctor. Here, this should help. Received the remote patient monitor. Colin's heart rate monitor is now activated. Press escape or right click to open menu. Excellent. Now, him having a heart attack will probably give me one too. Alright, so the heart rate monitor's up top. Senior Memory Traversal Agent, Sigmund Corporation. Notes, remote, okay. I think we're Gucci, baby.
Let's get on this grind, baby. Let's go hustle this baby.
Alright, Asher. Talk to you later, mate. Let's go get the stuff from the car. I have to talk to these kids again, goddamn. So surely there's a sprint button somewhere. Press Q or mouse, click to switch between characters. Okay. You can do that. Press Q or mouse click to switch between characters. She said that. Ah, there's a kid again. Got your daddy bear back, huh? Hey, you got your bear back? Yep, a nice lady in brown dress swooped it into the pond and got it for me. Swooped? Yeah, she didn't even touch the water. Right. Please tell your parents to watch your sugar intake. Hey, Dave, what's going on, my man? Done already? He didn't die on you, did he? No, just forgot something, but gosh, I sure hope not. Surely this is pretty good, come on. Oh, it's an old lady. Bonnie. Who's dying, dear? Pardon me, ma'am. That coat and tag, you're from Sigmund. If you're here, then someone's time is up. Colin Reeds, do you know him? I see. He and his wife used to stroll with my husband and me here every day. Please do your best for him, dear. You sound rather accepting of his fate. After years of seeing everyone around you go, it's hard not to be. But then, you of all people should know that. Not a very great occupation. I mean, actually, if you think about it, it's like Make-The-Wish Foundation. Like, it's very sweet, but it would be so tragic to work there. Like, it'd be sad. This is my car, right? Imagine if I forgot the keys. That'd be tragic. I'm guessing I don't have the file in here, huh? The file isn't in the car either. That doofus must have left it in the office. Dr. Rose, Roxanne Winters. Eva! Hey Roxy, still at the office? Yup, just waiting on the elevator. Not that you'd understand, with it opening instantly for you every time. What? That's a myth. I wait for the elevators too. Yeah. When was the last time it didn't open instantly? See? You're either freakishly lucky or... Okay. For pumpkin's sake. Look, Neil forgot the patient's file. Could you help us out? Okie dokie pokey lokey. Pocky lucky. Just give me a moment. Alright, well. I guess we can return. Or we're gonna call the other dude. Mission accomplished? Question mark. Neil, the file wasn't in the car. Shit, I forgot it at the office, didn't I? It's fine, I called Roxanne. She's gonna find it and send over a scan. Oh. Well, my office is locked, but she could check the printers in the lobby. Yep, she's on it. I'm heading back soon. Called by Roxanne, probably? Did you find it, Rox? Yep, it was just sitting on Neil's table. Cool beans. Just scan it and... Wait, Neil's table? You were inside Neil's office. Yep, you asked me to get the files, right? Yeah, but Neil said he had his door locked. Oh, a girl's got her ways. Elaborate. Not like that, silly. I just hacked his electronic lock like a slice of cheese. Oh, okay. Well, just get out of there and send me a scan, would you? Yep, on it. Yep, cheerio. I'll get air right on it, mate. You rock. Yeah, I saw the U Rock thing, it's a bit spish. Dr. Neil, what are you hiding? What? Hold on, what is this? You guys got everything else you need? Yep, Neil's setting up the machine right now. How's the weather out there? Huh? Is it nice out for a drive? It's not bad. I mean, neato. I think I'll just come over and get you the file in person then. Why? Just scan and send it over. Saves time for both of us. Well, we've got no patients today and it's boring here anyway. Boring. Anyhow, don't worry, I'll get there before you guys are done. See you both then. Okay, Roxy. Have a safe drive. What an odd ball, that Roxanne. Something's wrong. She found something. That's a bit weird. Okay, at least the time skips me back over there. That's fine. Appreciate that. Well, it's entered automated configuration mode. It does that now? Yep, my handiwork with the sole purpose of setting myself free to play hooky. But instead, I go to gather background info on the patient. Well, I'll go keep an eye on the patient. That's how you get lazy eye. Keep both eyes on him, please. Configuration system to patient net relink, whatever that was. What's in here? Is this like a... Anything I can help with, Doc? Back home. Talk to the apartment. A tour around the apartment while we wait for an excruciating slow colleague would be nice. Of course, I'll come with you. Ash has joined the party. Right. Let's look at the model again, because it wants me to. A model of a small fixed aircraft. That's a neat piece. Yeah, that's my dad's. He used to be an airline pilot. I guess it reminds him of his roots. Receive a note, retired pilot. Okay, so yeah, I'm using this sun as a way to discover things. Your parents' wedding photo, huh? Yeah, that's them. I remember being embarrassed about that picture as a kid, but it's kind of sweet that they kept it up so well. Pot of homegrown hibiscus. Huh, aren't those tropical? I wouldn't know any better. My mother takes care of them. We've had these around the house for as long as I can remember. I guess it's some kind of family tradition. Hibiscus, huh? The hibiscus. They're actually really nice flowers, though. We have them in our house in real life. Nothing really important in here. Looks like. It was just the bathroom. Toilet paper. Ooh, Eva's gonna love this. Hello? Code 32, Eva. Code 32. Rectified. Nah, I don't want to. Dang, name it, Neil. You know it drives me crazy when people just leave it on the counter. Put the toilet paper onto the dispenser. Magic word. Put the toilet paper onto the dispenser, please. Well, since you asked nicely. That's pretty funny. A falcon is in the nest. What falcon? Is this the freaking toilet paper on the dispenser or not? Yeah, it's there, as snug as could be. Thank heavens. Anyway, go get things wrapped up, I'm heading back. Well, that was just... not necessary. A dusty cello, with quite a few scratches across the board. This is my father's old cello. He played it a lot back in the day. Seems like it hasn't been touched in a while. Yeah, I guess it's hard on the wrist. He usually just plays the scales, though it's not exactly music to be enjoyed. An aged digital piano. He plays this too? No, this is my mother's. She used it to lull me to sleep, playing it back in the days. We all have our lullabies, mine's Beethoven's Fifth. Okay, just thanks for that. Alright. I think there's an upstairs area I need to. This is probably where the children live. Oh my god. An apartment with two flowers reminds me of a double-decker bus. Most of this floor is for maintenance. We just got a little storage room cut out. Sorry about the mess. Seems like they have been doing a bit of cleaning. Clean up. Okay, the kids aren't a part of this family. I think they're just random kids from the start front. Looks like they've missed one. I think I recognize that book. It's been around for quite a while. My dad kept it taped up. I guess he didn't want it to be thrown away. Could it be? Yep, it's taped up alright. He doesn't want anyone reading it, eh? Well, under normal circumstances, I'd say to leave it alone for privacy's sake, but he did sign up to become your client, so I don't know. Alright, I'm gonna put this back. But just so you know, if you weren't here, I'd be rampaging through this place remorselessly. Let's look somewhere else. Oh, actually, there's something else that might help you prepare. Could've said that before, mate. Could've said that before. Oh, by the way, I'm sorry for the right hand of the screen, how it's black. It's because for some reason my recording system won't actually record the full screen properly. So I've had to resort to actually, yeah, doing this. It's not that bad. I mean, it's pretty good. So, under me will probably be a day. So, I'll try and make it look pretty for you guys. Here's the family photo album. Goes way back. Thanks. Never too early to feel like a grandma. I'll go check on my father then. My colleague will be back soon. So I should go to the machine ready too. But I'll flip through this for a bit first. How about the file? Has Rock sent the scans? No. She said she's coming over to bring it in person. She what? Why? No clue. She said she was bored, but something felt odd. Then again, you know Roxanne. She's always a little cucumbered. Up in the head. Whoa, language, Ava. Anyway, I guess we could still start in the meantime. Your helmet's on the recliner. Memory traversal. Wait. Do you want to come? Before you begin, could you tell me what you'll be doing in there? We're going through his memories to grant him his last wish, Dar. I thought you already knew. Yes, I do know that, but how? What will you be actually doing? Well, actually don't do much. It's the machine that does most of the work. Says the technician. Who knows best? The machine calculates permutations of possibilities and creates a new tangent of life. In the form of memories, of course. It's an illusion, but to him, it would be indistinguishable memories of a lifetime. However, the permutations of the machine calculates would still have to be logically coherent. So it needs a starting point and a change in a key variable. And that's where we come in. We tunnel through his memories from the most recent to as far back as we need, drawing a line from now to then. We'd then be able to help Colin transfer his current motivations all the way to his past. So, in his simulated life rerun, he'll make all the kick-ass decisions and fulfill his own wish. Just by his own violation? Volition? Is that enough? I'd have thought that fulfilling wishes would take more than just effort and a second chance. I mean, can't you two just make whatever needs to happen happen? Perhaps, but one problem. He's not brain dead. there's a few things that uphold the illusion of reality. Illogical happenstances aren't one of them. And since the world still must be self-coherent, we can't do more than simply influence it. Besides, we don't get paid enough to generate memories manually. It's not a cave painting. There's a little need for interference, however. Anyhow, willpower is usually more than enough. Not everyone can reach their goals in life, in real life. Time changes them. Motivations come and go. They always start strong, then plateau, then fade. But in a simulation based on the mental state of a single moment, stretched through a lifetime, let's just say it's some powerful voodoo man. Anyhow, no amount of volitations gonna help a dead man. Shall we proceed? Yes, thank you for the explanation. I got you, fam. I don't know what's gonna happen in there, but good luck. Luck's for lotteries. We are professionals, mate. Stand back and watch, buddy. Oosh, sharp words. See you on the other side. Patient is stable and ready. Initializing memory traversal. Sequence 3, 2, 1. This should be Colin's last accessible memory. Yeah, and check out the reigning heavy sleeper champ over here. Leave that memory of hers alone. She's not our client. By the way, I wanted to ask earlier. What's with the helm you put on our patients? The equipment, it looked different. Oh, I just removed the casing during maintenance, that's all. Then why didn't you put it back? Hey, that reminds me. Did you know I added a new feature? New feature? Behold! Never mind, forget I asked. Hi-ya-ya-ya-ya! 01001 characters. Customization. Oh my god, Dr. Watts is a G. Oh my god, I can... 1920s, 1960s. Timeless. I want the side part, man. Smooth yet manly. Hipster stash. Amish paradise. Rich old baron, baby. Smooth yet manly. I like the smooth yet manly, but... Rich oil baron. Even blacker. Gold trimming. Dead sock puppets. Tamud pattern. One red, one gone. Mithril. Plus 58 GI. Dinosaurs plain like. Alright, let's go on. Dead sock puppets, baby. Smooth but manly just suits it more, I reckon, because of the glasses. Okay, I'll do the girls well. No. Ta-da! Just why? Well, I figured if we're gonna spend so much time working here, we might as well travel in style. Oops, did I say we? Sorry, I meant... Oh, wait, yeah, that's exactly what I meant. Tag, you're it. Neil, you son of a... Long flowing locks. Saucy bangs. Classic Eva. Grand mustache. Wizard's beard. Rachel face carpet. And classic Eva. Plain white, bright teal, giraffe print, fuzzy cucumber pattern. Oh, you gotta go with the cucumber pattern, baby. More hole than sock. Rainbow stripes, baby. Rare silk, plain white. You gotta go with the bloody cucumber pattern. It's actually a pretty good game so far, man. Well, that could have been worse. I guess I'll wear it like this until we find Colin. You got lucky this time. I was really counting on something more face comb worthy. I don't want to know what you meant by that. Nice socks, by the way. The current memory's position in time can be viewed by moving the mouse towards the top of the screen. Alright, let's turn off world interaction before we wake her up. After all that, I'm surprised we didn't already. And just like that, guys, I'm going to end this video right here, actually. I'm going to save that, see how long I've been playing for. I've been playing for 30 minutes, so yeah, it's probably a good way to end. I hope you guys enjoyed. Like, I'm really enjoying this so far. It's quite a traversing game. Very, very unique. It's very sad so far. I can see why it's so touching to people. Like, I can tell why people enjoy it. So anyway, thank you for watching again. Please like, subscribe, and comment a new game if you want me to play it. Just comment whatever you want, basically. I don't really care, to be honest with you. Thanks again. See you guys in the next episode.